हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नमस्कार। सी ऑन द बोर्ड हियर इट इज रिटन स्फेरिकल शेल और यू कैन से इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज्ड स्फेरिकल शेल। ओके, शेल यू नो अ थिन वॉल्ड स्फेयर। ओके, इट इज हॉलो स्फेयर, थिन वॉल्ड हॉलो स्फेयर, इट इज शेल एंड यूनिफॉर्म चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज देयर। The shell may be of conducting material, may be of non-conducting material, or may be the charges are arranged in a spherical shape, in the shape of a spherical shell in vacuum. So overall you can say this is distribution, uniform charge distribution, and say this charge density is sigma. So surface charge density is sigma. Okay, surface charge density is how much? Say this is sigma, so we denote with the help of sigma, or we denote with sigma. Okay, so this is application of Gauss law. So we have to find out electric field due to uniformly charged spherical shell. So and electric field you have to obtain outside the shell as well as inside the shell. In the case of point charge, you know the electric field is radially outward direction or radially inward direction, but this is spherical shell. What should be there in this case? What should be direction of electric field? And by using the field pattern, we drew the direction of electric field in the case of plane sheet, uniformly charged plane sheet, in case of uniformly charged straight long wire. So here let us see what should be direction of electric field due to uniformly charged spherical shell, and outside it what should be there. Suppose this is point P. And here in the figure, spherical shell is what? I have drawn figure completely. I have drawn this figure. Okay, before starting the video. So I have drawn this figure before starting the video to save time. So this is spherical shell. A positive charge marked here. And these are some concentric spheres. We will talk about this thing. Okay, so this is point P. Suppose this is point P, this is a spherical shell, and certainly a spherical shell has its center, and a radial direction can be taken through this point, or a normal to the surface of a spherical charge distribution can be taken here, which passes through this point P. Okay, so about this line, this charge distribution is symmetric. Okay, about this line which joins the point P and center of distribution, this is center of distribution and this is point P. A line joining these two points, certainly it is in radial direction and it is perpendicular to the surface of charge distribution. So see the field here, due to this charge in this region, electric field at point P will be in this direction, okay, radially outward, because I am taking this charge positive. So what should be electric field at P due to this charge and this charge, this charge and this charge, this charge and this charge? So due to this charge, electric field here is like this, and due to this charge again, the charge in this region of the distribution, again electric field at P is here. So due to this charge here, charge in this region, electric field at P is how much? In this direction. And same way, electric field due to this charge in this region at P is alliteration. So again we are seeing asymmetry. Okay, clearly it is symmetry, and resultant field is in the direction of radius, or you can say in the radial direction. So radially outward direction again, like the point, like in the case of positive charges, point charges. Okay, point positive charges. So here, so due to this spherical charge distribution, again electric field is in radial direction, and for positive distribution, certainly it is radially outward. So doubtlessly, we can write the field outside the spherical charge distribution, spherical shell here, it is radially outward, or you can say in radial direction. Okay. Now we have to apply Gauss law to find out electric field due to this charge distribution. So Gauss law result is what? So Gauss law result is how much? Total flux through closed surface is what? Q upon epsilon naught, or again integration E dot ds. This E dot ds is flux through a surface element, and integration gives total flux, and this is Q upon epsilon naught. So this result we have to use here. So for this, to apply Gauss law, what do we do? We imagine, or we assume, a surface enclosing charge, or a portion of charge distribution. Okay, so this surface here in this case is enclosing whole charge distribution. Okay, this is spherical charge distribution, and this surface dotted inside also. So outside is there, so we have to find out electric field outside the spherical charge distribution. So a point P is here where we have to find out electric field, and this electric field is certainly in the radially outward direction, and the Gaussian surface assumed it must pass through this point. Okay, so this is electric field here in this region. So again we will follow the same pattern, means we will calculate the flux through surface element, surface of what? Gaussian surface, and then we will sum over this flux over the whole surface. So this is electric field in outward direction, and surface vector or area vector is here, area vector of surface element, it is in same direction of electric field again. If field is there, so we have to apply Gauss law. We don't know what should be electric field due to this distribution. We know about point charge. Now we know about the surface charge distribution, plane sheet, and we know about the linear charge distribution. But here this is spherical charge distribution, and electric field here is E, suppose, and flux through here is E dot ds. Again, so flux through, let the electric flux through a surface element of Gaussian surface. This is what Gaussian surface? This is concentric to given charge distribution, concentric and spherical. Okay. So here we are doing what? We are finding out electric field outside the distribution. So first, outside the shell. Okay, outside the shell. So Gaussian surface is what? It is concentric to the given distribution. This is Gaussian surface. We have to find out electric field at P outside this distribution, and a Gaussian surface we can assume passing through P, which is concentric to this charge distribution here, and it is spherical. Let electric flux through a surface element of Gaussian surface is d phi, then d phi equals E dot ds. This is one, and total flux through the Gaussian surface is how much? Phi equals integration E dot ds. Again, this is 2, and from Gauss law, but this is total flux, but from Gauss law, total flux is what? Phi total equals Q enclosed divided by epsilon naught. So let total charge Q is given to the spherical charge distribution. Okay, means total charge Q is uniformly distributed on the spherical shell. So Q upon epsilon naught. And this is let third. So we have to compare this. So from 2 again, from symmetry E parallel to delta I, okay. From equation 2 again, okay, E is parallel to ds, got the symmetry, okay. Whatever the symmetry here, E is in a real direction and spherical surface there, so its area vector is also in the real direction. So E is parallel to ds. And value of E is constant, because according to symmetry, if field is here E, then same field will be here, because this is perfectly symmetric situation. Okay. So E is, the magnitude of E is constant of the Gaussian surface. Okay. Gaussian surface has electric field constant everywhere because it is symmetric. So E is constant. So you can take out here, then phi equals E ds and this E ds is how much? E into, see, this E is not known. In case of point charge, E is known. If point charge is placed here, this distance is r, then this field will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square. But here, this is spherical charge distribution, this is not a point charge. So E is how much? Then it is 4 pi r square. This is total area of Gaussian surface, and phi, this is result, how much? It is 4. So total flux again from Gauss law, from 3, it is q upon epsilon naught, q is total charge here distributed. Then compare 3 and 4. On comparing equations 3 and 4, so we get how much? E into 4 pi r square equals how much? Q upon epsilon naught. So E equals 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square. Oh, this is same result as you have seen. seen in the case of point charge. This is same field like this. If charge, this Q charge would be here at center, at the center, then same field at P would be seen here. Okay? If same charge, this Q, if concentrates at the center, again the same field will be obtained here. Because this formula suggests, this formula gives the same thing. If whole, this charge is distributed here, but it looks like if whole charge is concentrated here, because this formula is according to point charge. So we get same result here. So this result shows that as if whole charge is concentrated at the center of distribution. Okay? And case of point charge? In case of point charge, we have same field at P. So remember this comparison. If charge is located at a point or it is uniformly distributed around it with the spherical symmetry, okay. So if whole charge is here or it is distributed about this point uniformly and symmetrically, then same result would be seen outside the distribution. So this is for outside the distribution. Till now this is not certain whether this field inside will be in the same way or not, okay. But to an outside point, this charge behaves as if whole charge is concentrated at the center, okay. So this is for outside point. So to an outside point, okay. So this result shows that as if whole charge is concentrated at the center of the distribution. Okay. Now see the result for point inside the spherical cell or point inside the distribution. So inside the field inside the cell. Okay. So second one is what? Field inside the cell. So inside, suppose this point P is inside here, P dash. So let P dash is an interior point, okay. So a Gaussian surface passing through this point will not enclose any charge. Okay. Point. Then Gaussian surface through this point, okay, through this point will not enclose any charge inside it, okay. So what will happen? What will be about Gauss law? So Gauss law will give here E dot ds equals 0 upon epsilon naught equals 0. So So since there is no charge inside the Gaussian surface, then total flux will be zero. Okay, then total flux through Gaussian surface is how much? Phi equals E dot ds, integration E dot ds, and it is 0. So, E dot ds integration is 0 if and only if, okay, E is perpendicular to ds everywhere or E is 0 everywhere on the Gaussian surface. So, this is only possible. E dot ds, so this is 0, so E dot ds is 0. E dot ds equals 0, this implies that either E is 0 everywhere or vector E is perpendicular to ds everywhere. Okay. So, let us check what should be true here. So, consider this point P, or think about this point P. This is how much? This is positive charge, and at P its field should be here. This is positive charge, its field should be here, and this is positive charge, its field should be here. This is positive charge, its field should be here. This is positive charge, its field should be here. So, this resultant field should be radial direction due to these charges. But due to these charges, what should be there? Due to these charges, field due to this charge, it is smaller, but it is here. Field due to this charge, at this point, it is here. Field due to this charge is here. So, overall comes 0 if it would be non-zero. Okay, if it would be non-zero, then certainly it would be in this direction, not perpendicular to surface. Okay, so surface element here, you can take radially in radial direction surface elements. So electric field, if it would be there, it would be parallel to delta S. Okay, these are delta S, but this is not possible. Okay. So, E is perpendicular to ds, this is not true. For this, electric field should be there here, in this direction or in this direction. For this element, ds is here, and if E is perpendicular to ds, then certainly it should be in this direction, here or here. But certainly it is not possible. If field is non-zero, then it will be here, inside or outside. But certainly this is not possible. This perpendicular is not possible. So then what will happen? Then E is zero only. Inside field is zero. So E is perpendicular to ds is not possible. E is not perpendicular to ds. That is electric field inside will never be perpendicular to ds. Okay. So this indicates that magnitude of E is 0 everywhere inside. Okay. So that point means this whole charge distribution behaves like a point charge to an outside point, not to the interior point. So remember this thing, interior of the shell, if there is no charge inside, then field will be zero. So field is outside or very close to the surface. On the surface is not very much defined, but we imagine this thing outward, okay, or normal to the surface. So what we on the surface, field on the surface, so this R will become capital R. If radius is R, suppose this radius is R here, this, then field on the surface, field on the surface, okay. So from first result, outside the distribution here, from this result, R equals R, okay. From the result of field on outside the surface, what is there? R equals R. So field on the surface, okay, or this is on the surface equals 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square. So we write this thing here, okay. And we can see the graph here. On the same figure, let us see the graph of variation of electric field. So variation is what? Imagine this thing. This is value of electric field. So I have taken graph here. It is not necessary to keep the sphere on the line, but here I am showing with respect to distance here. So this point O is here, and here is the value of electric field E, magnitude of E, and this is distance R from the center. Center means here. So from the center, we are going away from the center here. So field inside is zero. So up to this distance, center to this distance, this is spherical surface, and center to this distance, field is zero. So this is distance, how much? This is R equals capital R. R is radius of spherical distribution. So here field is zero. Everywhere field is zero. So field value is zero. And this is maximum on the surface. Okay. This is maximum. So electric field value on the surface is maximum. So maximum is here. This is maximum value. And like this, so at this point it is undefined, okay, because it has zero value and also it has maximum value. So this is very precise thing, and this is very undefined thing. This is undefined case at this point, but just outside this point, what is there is directly proportional to 1 upon r square. So this is like this, okay. So graph is here. Electric field versus R. Okay. So this is all about applications, and I hope you have learned many things. You have no confusion, but still if there is some doubt, please make me to know this problem and we will together solve this problem. Okay. So thank you very much to cooperate, and have a good day. Thank you.